Million-dollar listing LA Tracy Tudor goes international as ambassador of Royal Atlantis in Dubai. Tracy Tudor made the leap to international businesswoman representing the Royal Atlantis in Dubai on Thursday's episode of Million Dollar Listing Los Angeles. The 43-year-old real estate agent traveled to Dubai to meet with Assam Galadari, director of Royal Atlantis Resort and Residences. Maria, who shortlisted Tracy for the project, assured her that she knew the details. "This is my chance to become the global ambassador to the US for the Royal Atlantis. So I feel ready, but I'm incredibly nervous because it's the developer who gets the final say on whether or not I get the job, so this meeting is crucial," Tracy said in a confessional. Assam said the project was not just for Dubai, it's for the world, and asked Tracy to convince him that she was up for the challenge. "Well, I think the most important thing to understand, and particularly in selling luxury prime real estate at this level, is that it's about relationships. It's about the people that I bring to the table," Tracy said. Tracy Tudor is one of the realtors on Million Dollar Listing LA, but what do we know about her personal life? Does she have a boyfriend? Is she dating? "And the buyers and the agents that have known me for 20 years trust that I don't represent properties that I don't stand behind. And, candidly, there's a level of taste and a level of understanding luxury that I think your agent, your ambassador in the US, needs to have. I believe I'm that person," she added. She was asked during the interview where she was from, and Tracy answered that she was born and raised in Los Angeles, oh my God. California, such a lovely dream, Assam said. He revealed that he used to travel a lot and loved the Los Angeles air and landscape, as well as the classic rock song Hotel California. "Every time I listen, it is like my first time," Assam said as Tracy agreed, saying, "The Eagles are amazing." Tracy was assigned to co-host an upcoming Brokers Open as a challenge by Assam. Her team member Erica quizzed her on details before the event, and Tracy knew there were 231 apartments, 3 different finishes and 82 different floor plans. Tracy during the event showed off the sales suite of a 2-bedroom, 1,800 square feet condominium with a listing price of $1,900,000. Assam arrived and shadowed Tracy as she gave a tour highlighting the artwork and fixtures for brokers. "You just don't see this level of detail, in my opinion, in certainly anything in the States," Tracy said. Assam after the event told Tracy that he was pleased with how she explained the development. "I was really impressed. How about if you can join us as an ambassador?" Assam said. Tracy gladly accepted the offer and said she was looking forward to sharing it with her buyers. She got back to work upon her return and held a meeting with her team, including new assistant Eleanor. "We took a trip to Dubai, and we got the job. So we're international," she told the team. In October 2017, Maltas was recognized by The Hollywood Reporter as one of Hollywood's top 30 real estate agents. That month, Maltas sold a Frank Gehry-designed home in Brentwood for $8.1 million to developer Tom Safran. Prior to that, in July, she brokered the $11.8 million sale of the John Lautner-designed Stevens House in Malibu, California to Edward Norton. Tracy Tudor Maltas was married to Jason Maltas for 13 years, and had 2 daughters with him. The family lived in Brentwood, Los Angeles. In February 2018, the couple filed for divorce. With almost 20 years of experience, Tracy Tudor is one of the top agents at Douglas Elliman Beverly Hills and is an integral part of their sports and entertainment division. She has an undeniably strong presence and a confidence that has propelled her into the rooms of some of the most powerful people in LA, representing some of the most noteworthy brands in real estate, and iconic architects such as Frank Gehry, John Lautner, and Pierre Koenig. Tracy has consulted for the luxury 5-star hotel and resort, Amangiri in Canyon Point, Utah, on the sales of over $400 million in branded real estate. She is also a representative of one of the most exciting new developments to come to Los Angeles, the West Hollywood Edition Hotel and Residences, designed by British architect John Pawson and created by visionary hotelier Ian Schrager. Most recently, she has been chosen to be the U.S. ambassador for the Royal Atlantis Resort and Residences in Dubai, a breathtaking structure designed by award-winning architects Cohn Pedersen Fox, scheduled to be completed in Q4 2019. A native to California, Tracy has lived all over Los Angeles, from Hidden Hills to the Hollywood Hills. Growing up the daughter of Ronald Tudor, one of the most successful civil and building contractors in the country, Tracy was introduced to real estate at an early age. Shortly after graduating from the University of Southern California, she went to work for her father, acquiring a wealth of knowledge and a steadfast work ethic. Tracy said she had to launch the brand in a few weeks and wanted to kick it off with a dinner for 30 brokers with international clients. This event is crucial. My goal is to not just be a part of the Royal Atlantis but be a part of Assam's team on his next development, which you know is gonna be around the corner, she said in a confessional. Tracy shimmered in a golden metallic dress at the event where she gave a presentation about Royal Atlantis Resort and Residences. Maria showed up adding some pressure and Tracy warned her guests Josh Altman, Josh Flagg and James Harris not to fight. Tracy during dinner described Dubai as Hawaii on steroids and during her presentation called the Royal Atlantis development the most iconic project in Dubai to date. Tracy during dinner described Dubai as Hawaii on steroids and during her presentation called the Royal Atlantis development the most iconic project in Dubai to date. Maria afterward assured Tracy that Assam would be pleased with the turnout at the dinner. Tracy called it a total success and quipped that hopefully her clients will do buy it. Her dinner also saw real estate rivals Altman and Flagg agree to an odd alliance. Altman proposed going to a listing appointment together for the Antelope property in Bel Air near Mulholland Drive. The 5-acre property hasn't been on the market for 30 years and the owners were seeking two brokerages to cast a wider net. Tracy Tudor Maltes was born and raised in Hidden Hills, California, a city and gated community in Los Angeles County, California. Maltes grew up in a real estate family. Her father, Ronald Tudor, is the CEO of Tudor Perini, one of the largest general contractors in the United States. Her sister and sister-in-law are interior designers. Her former husband, Jason Maltes, is a residential contractor. In 1997, Tudor Maltes graduated from the University of Southern California with a Bachelor of Arts in Theater Arts. Tracy Tudor Maltes is one of the top real estate agents at Douglas Elliman Beverly Hills and is an integral part of their sports and entertainment division. She has represented some of the most noteworthy brands in real estate and iconic architects such as Frank Gehry, John Lautner, and Pierre Koenig. Tudor Maltes has consulted for the luxury five-star hotel and resort, Amangiri in Canyon Point, Utah on the sales of over $400 million in branded real estate. She is also a representative of one of the West Hollywood Edition Hotel and Residences, designed by British architect John Pawson and created by visionary hotelier Ian Schrager. She was also chosen to be the U.S. ambassador for the Royal Atlantis Resort and Residences in Dubai, designed by award-winning architects Cohn Peterson Fox, scheduled to be completed in Q4 2019. Maltes is the first woman to ever join the cast of Million Dollar Listing Los Angeles and only the second woman to be a part of the franchise. The short-lived Million Dollar Listing Miami installment featured Samantha DeBianchi. Maltes, Altman, Flagg, Harris, and Parnes will be returning for Season 11 of Million Dollar Listing Los Angeles, which premieres on January 3, 2018. After almost 3 years at Tudor Perini, Tracy transitioned into a career in residential real estate and has never looked back. While expanding her business worldwide and taking on more new developments, Tracy strives to maintain a work-life balance by spending time with her family and friends. Altman at Tracy's dinner suggested they put their differences aside to get the listing. "What do you think?" Altman asked. Flagg said that he was torn before admitting that he actually liked his longtime rival. "You know what the problem is in our relationship? We're too similar. I think the problem is that we're so competitive that we don't get along, but I actually do like your style," Flagg said. Altman proposed surprising the buyer by showing up together and after closing the deal splitting the marketing 50-50. Flagg said he was up for it as long as there wasn't any tricky business and they shook hands on working together. Altman and Flagg were then shown a week later meeting up just ahead of the listing appointment. "Just follow my lead," Altman told him. "Really, I don't want to lose the listing," Flagg shot back. "Not everyone has your interesting sense of humor," Altman warned him. "You mean my panache," Flagg retorted. The episode ended with Altman and Flagg walking in together for the listing meeting. Million Dollar Listing Los Angeles will return next week on Bravo. Do you know 43-year-old real estate agent Tracy Tudor has made the leap to international businesswoman representing the Royal Atlantis in Dubai? Know everything here about Thursday's episode of Million Dollar Listing Los Angeles and share your thoughts in the comment box. Don't forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel for more related videos.